Who is Ali Khamenei, the supreme leader of Iran's regime? Ali Khamenei is the current supreme leader of the mullahs regime in Iran. Khamenei is ultimately responsible for all human rights violations across Iran and terrorist meddling in other countries as the most powerful official of the theocratic regime with the final say about all state matters. Khamenei became supreme leader in 1989 following the death of regime founder Ruhollah Khomeini. The supreme leader's office, under the supervision of Khamenei and his eldest son Mojtaba, is an entity that oversees dozens of security, political, and economic institutions. Khamenei's wealth is estimated to be close to $200 billion. In October 1981, Khamenei was appointed as president. In 1980, he was responsible for the suppression of minorities in Kurdistan and Khorramshahr by the Revolutionary Guards IRGC. According to a statement issued on April 26, 2019 by the U.S. Embassy in Baghdad, Khamenei controls a financial empire worth an estimated $200 billion. Khamenei also controls financial giants such as the foundation of the execution of Imam Khomeini's order, ICO, with assets estimated at $95 billion. Khamenei also controls the Mullahs Afan Foundation, which oversees assets left by the monarchist regime of the Shah and its affiliates. The foundation owns thousands of houses, residential complexes, villas, agricultural lands, factories, and palaces. The Mullahs Afan Foundation's turnover has never been announced. The Astan-e AQR Charity Foundation is one of the oldest financial and religious foundations in Iran. This entity is another example of how the clerical regime is taking advantage of the Iranian people's religious beliefs to pursue its ominous objectives. AQR is not accountable to the government and reports to Khamenei himself. According to the International Monetary Fund, the foundation's investment in the fiscal year of 2014 was about $188 billion. AQR manages all financial endowments accrued over the past few decades, and Khamenei himself appoints its custodian. As the highest official of the clerical regime, Khamenei is the main figure responsible for human rights violations in Iran. This includes the execution of 120,000 members of opposition groups, mostly the MEK, the 1988 massacre of over 30,000 political prisoners, torturing and imprisonment of thousands of dissidents who were mostly members and supporters of the Iranian opposition People's Mujahideen Organization of Iran, suppression of religious and ethnic minorities, suppression of women in particular, suppression of the 1999 student uprising, suppression of the 2009 post-election uprising, suppression of the 2017-2018 nationwide protests, killing of 1,500 protesters in the aftermath of the nationwide November 2019 protests, the assassination of dissidents inside the country and abroad, such as Professor Kazem Rajavi, and terrorism plots such as the 2018 Iranian opposition gathering at Villepinte in France, and the killing sprees targeting people in Syria, Yemen, and Iraq. Khamenei was the regime president during the 1988 massacre of political prisoners. Have we abolished the death penalty? No. In the Islamic Republic, we have the death penalty for those who deserve it, he said at the time. If they are connected to the MEK, what should we do? They are sentenced to death and we execute them. We are not joking around about this. After the death of regime founder Ruhollah Khomeini during the 1990s, Khamenei launched a campaign aimed at eliminating the mullahs' domestic and foreign-based opposition figures. The first target was Abdulrahman Qasemlu, leader of the Iranian Kurdish group KDPI. Another renowned figure assassinated in 1990 was Dr. Kazem Rajavi, brother to Iranian resistance leader Masoud Rajavi. He was hated by the mullahs for exposing the regime's crimes against humanity, especially against political prisoners and prisoners of conscience. Without realizing the shift in the international spectrum, the mullahs once again attempted to carry out another terrorist attack in 2018. This time, they sent one of their senior diplomats, Asadullah Asadi, to plot a bombing targeting the annual Iranian resistance gathering in Villepinte near Paris. Asadi was apprehended by German authorities red-handed on German soil after delivering the explosives to the hit team in Luxembourg. He is now facing trial in Belgium. This is the first time an Iranian diplomat is being prosecuted for direct involvement in terrorism. The power struggle and ambiguities surrounding Khomeini's succession have left him and his regime in a weak state and are making it harder for him to maintain hold on power. Ebrahim Raisi, the current judiciary chief, is seen as a potential figure to succeed Khomeini. However, it is not clear who will eventually become Khomeini's successor.